Hello everyone, it's John here from Winning Solutions Inc. and today I will be bringing you all another Microsoft Access Expert template walkthrough. I will be showing you where to find the template database on a website, how to download the template database demo, and how to use the demo properly. Most of our templates are not designed to be used on their own. Instead, they are designed in a way that makes it simple and smooth to integrate into an existing database that you're already using. You can also build a more robust Microsoft Access database that is built around one of our templates. If you would like to create a new database that is based off one of our templates and don't know how, or don't have the time to do so, let us know and we'd be happy to help you getting the database that 100% fits your needs. With most of our templates that we offer, there are three different versions that you can purchase: a compiled runtime version, one for internal use, and one for unlimited developer use. The compiled runtime version is a run-as-is version without the paid full version of Microsoft Access using free Access runtime from Microsoft. It can be integrated into your existing Access application, but you will not be able to make any modifications to the forms, reports, modules, etc. This option is more for those of you who don't see any need to make any customizations to the template. The internal use is a version that allows you to use or modify the databases however you wish within the organization. The unlimited developer use allows you to use the database template however you wish for any applications you develop. And it also allows you to distribute the template as part of a database you create. Winning Solutions Inc.'s templates have a strong advantage over shrink wrap software that you purchase from a store or website. With our templates, you receive the source code along with your purchase, so you are able to customize and update the database as you please. With shrink wrap software, you do not receive the source code when purchasing the software, and that means you can't update or customize the database. In our video today, we will be working with a demo version of our database template. A demo is a simple way that you can view or try out our database templates so that you can determine if you would like to purchase the database template or not. This is great for customers due to the fact that all of our sales are final. And our sales are final because we give you the source code when you purchase a template, and once we give you that source code, there's really no way you can return it. If you would like to test our demos for multiple days, you're free to do so. You just have to leave the database open so the data you entered will not be wiped. Our demos are designed so that once you close the demo, all the data entered is wiped from the database. And you have to purchase the full version if you would like to save your data that you enter. Upon downloading a demo, you have to unzip the downloaded file. And zipped files make it much easier to send and download large files over the web, so that's why we do that. Unzipping a file is very simple, though. All you have to do is extract the file so you have access to the uncompressed file. If you do not know how to do it or don't understand how to unzip a file, check out our YouTube channel and watch the How to Unzip One of Our Files video tutorial to learn this simple step. The link to that video is in the description of this video, actually. So now let us get into downloading and testing one of our own demos. All right, we're going to start off by going to our website, microsoftaccessexpert.com. On the top of the website, there is a toolbar right up here, and this is all the various ways to contact Winning Solutions Inc. And if you go over to the sidebar on the left and go under Database Templates for Sale, and then click on Database Templates List. All right, this is a view of all of our templates that we offer. And as you can see, it's broken up into categories. First one is Most Popular, second is Appointment and Scheduling, calendars, and so on, all the way down to database tools and miscellaneous templates. Today, I will be showing you the Access Financial Accountant Appointment Tracking Database Template. What you will need to do is download the demonstration that correctly corresponds to the version of access your computer has. Once the file has downloaded, go ahead and open it. Next, you will need to extract that file since it is in a zipped folder. So just hit extract all. And now you'll be able to open the database without any issues. Alright, so this is just a security notice that pops up, just alerting you that this database is coming from the web and it can be potentially harmful to your computer. But I can assure you that this database is safe. So just go ahead and click open. Alright, so this is the Financial Accountant Appointment Tracking Database. It's great for keeping track of all of your appointments and all of your clientele in one spot. To start, we'll do Add New Client. Alright, and here's the client form. And for now, I'm just going to fill out first and last name, then an email, and an address. Alright, and as you can see, there's also plenty of other information that you can add, such as like phone numbers, notes, call history, appointment history, and payment history, as well as a picture of the client if you want to, and then job title up here. But this is all I'm going to do for now, and I'm going to hit save and close. So now that this client is in the database, we can search for him. So just go to search client. And we are going to search by his last name, Smith. And as you can see, there's all sorts of other criteria that you can search by. And search. Okay, perfect. This is the client that we just created. And from here, you can double click on it. And it'll bring up the client form again. And you can edit or delete any information that you want to. And you can also export the search results to Excel. And that would pull all of this information into a new workbook for you. So, perfect. Alright, and next thing we're going to do is add an appointment to the database. To do that, go to Calendar View. Alright, so here's the calendar. This is the daily view. You can also view the weekly view, bi-weekly, month, and month day. Okay, let's go back to the daily view. And so as you can see, today is June 13th, 2016. And you can go forward or back a day if you want to by hitting the left or left or right arrow keys up here. And if you want to pick a specific day out of the year, you can just click the up arrow. All right. And let's make an appointment for noon. So just double click on this time slot right here, and the appointment form will show up. And client, John Smith. Accountant, let's just do accountant 1 for right now. You can change any of that information in the Dropbox, and I'll show you how to do that later. And type, let's do individual for $50. As you can see, the invoice amount went up as I did that. So there you go, group was 60. And location, location 1. You can also add appointment notes if you want to. And then you can add extra workers and payment information. So start time, you can change that as well. And I'm going to select a custom color. And let's make this appointment blue. And then hit save and close. All right, so when you have a lot of appointments back to back, it's easy to tell, or it's easy to distinguish between when one appointment ends and another one begins. If you use different colors, it makes it really easy. So that's why I did that. Yeah, and we can also search the calendar by a certain accountant. If you only want to see accountant 1's appointments, you can do that. And likewise, accountant 2 shouldn't have any, because I haven't added any into the database yet. So that all looks good. All right, and now that that appointment is in the database, we can search for it. So we can search by a certain accountant. That might be the easiest. You can also search by subject, location, start date, end date. I'm just going to run search, and it'll bring up all the appointments for accountant 1. And from here, you can double click this and view it in the calendar. Or we can go back and view it in the appointment form and then double click it. And now it's going to bring up the appointment form, and you can edit any information or delete the appointment if you want to. You can also export the search results to Excel Alloc Calendar or Alloc Task. And you can also do a print detailed version, or you can do a print summary. Okay. And that's pretty much all there is to the search function. All right, back to the main menu. And next we'll take a look at maintenance lookups. So here's where you can change all that drop-down information that we saw earlier, such as like accounts, location, service type. Let's change location. Let's do location 3. We will change that to Ames, and then we can also add a location just by hitting the asterisk down low. So as long as you keep adding more, there's always going to be an extra space where you can add. So, and then let's close. And it'll save automatically, so don't worry about that. And just to make sure that it worked, we will double click on another appointment and check the location. Perfect. Location 3 changed to Ames and the park was added. All right, next thing we'll take a look at is calendar setup. And here's where you can change all the calendar parameters, such as first day of the week. You can change that to whatever day you want. And start time and end time, change those as well. Alright, and then calendar colors. You can do the same thing. Change button colors, font colors, whatever you want. And we'll just save and close. And the last thing we're going to take a look at is reports. So we have to enter a start date. Let's make that the 6th. And an end date. Let's make that the 20th. So a 2-week period. And from here you can print invoices, accounts receivable, and a cash ledger. I'll just do print invoices since they all work the same. So yeah, since the appointment that we created was within that time parameter, it shows all the information for it. So perfect. All right, that's pretty much all there is to this database. It's pretty easy to operate and powerful at the same time, so it's a great tool to use. I'm going to go ahead and thank you guys for taking your time to watch this Microsoft Access Expert template walkthrough brought to you by Winning Solutions, Inc. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please feel free to give us a like or subscribe to our YouTube channel for tons of other walkthroughs and tutorials. As always, feel free to contact us for any of your IT needs, whether it be programming needed, you want to buy a template, or need help customizing a template. Contact us whenever you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and post our contact information in the description below of this video. Also, you can find us on about any social media website. Feel free to follow us or like us on any of those, and have a great day.